Jonathan has asked, if you are building a harness section of a harness for a much larger gauge wire, such as 14 to 10 gauge, how might you go about doing that? Right, so the process really is no different. If you're talking about 14 gauge through to 10 gauge, you're starting to talk about some pretty serious sized wire there. 14 gauge you might consider on a high current draw, a fan, or maybe a pump. But for the mainstream stuff that's going to be involved in our engine harness itself, there would be no need to ever have wiring that is that gauge. So normally, just to give you an example, the wiring for the engine itself, the actuators, the sensors on the engine would probably be between 24 and maybe 20 gauge will handle, depending on a few factors, somewhere around about 7 or 8 amps, just to give you a bit of a ballpark, which is plenty for just about anything that you're likely to be involved with. So when it comes to integrating the larger gauge wires like this with a harness, again, it comes down to the different techniques. If you're talking about concentrically twisted harnesses, we do need to consider that it's difficult to use dramatically different gauges of wire in a single layer. So what I would probably do there is try and incorporate the larger gauge wires somewhere towards the core of the wiring harness, and then as we build out, we're going to be able to drop down to the same size wire, so possibly a 22 or a 24 gauge conductor, just for an example. So hopefully that's answered your question there, Jonathan.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.